What's up, guys? This is Dwight here with Auction Up. Please remember to like my videos and to subscribe to my channel. There's constantly more content coming. Right now, I have a compilation video for you guys. I haven't been to an auction lately because it's just, I have so much stuff and I'm still taking pictures and listing it. But in the meantime, I've been getting a lot of sales, which is awesome. So what I've been trying to do was go backwards on my, you know, with the original videos, but I'm starting to think maybe I should just start this week, you know, go through some of the really cool sales I got this week and just keep you guys up to date, because I've had some killer sales this week. I wanted to start off with that picture on the screen, but it was a sale that I got this week that there was two of them that were just absolutely killer. Let me see if I'm gonna pull those up first. I plan on going to an auction on Tuesday. It's like one of my favorite auctions, as long as it doesn't snow, because it's supposed to snow this week up here. Tomorrow, I think they're expecting 8 more inches. But, you know, it's wintertime still, but it's almost over. Then the springtime will kick in, and my videos are really going to start to flow, because I'll have yard sales, auctions, and flea markets. So it's going to be super profitable for me. But, as always, please remember to like my videos and to subscribe to my channel. And here's the first item of the day. I bought this camera for roughly $20. And it sold for $125. It's a vintage Polaroid 110B land camera. I found them off and on over the years, and they always sell, and they sell very quickly. They are a little annoying to open. They're a little tricky, but once you figure out how to open it, it's not too bad. But every time it stumps me, my wife has to come to my rescue. But this sale was an awesome sale. $20, turn around, flip it for $125. Shipping, $10. Can't beat that. Another huge sale I got this week was this book right here. It's really nothing overly exciting about it, but the one thing that is truly exciting is the fact that it's worth $400. And it literally, we listed it for 7 days. It had one watcher. It closed, and I didn't do anything. It sat there unsold with one watcher. So yesterday I decided, let me go ahead and get this relisted since somebody was watching it. And when I left work, boom, sold. Awesome sale, $400. There's very few people that can be like, eh, to that. Now, I remember when I purchased this book. This book was purchased at an auction in a box lot. In the box lot, I paid $20 roughly for it. And I think it was two lots. And it must have had 15 books. And I said, there should be a gem in there. Well, there were multiple gems. But I didn't realize it had a gem this good in there. But $400 for this book. You can't beat it. Made my day. This was just a random belt buckle. I'm sure I didn't buy the box lot for this. It was just in one of them at an auction. It's a leather belt buckle, but for $20, $20 plus $7.70 in shipping. Hey, why not? Magazines. Old magazines sell. They can be a little tricky and frustrating, but if you're patient, you can start figuring out which ones do and don't sell. And they typically come in like larger lots, and you just got to kind of flip through them. But when you're paying, you know, getting stuff for like a penny on a dollar, well, it's more like a dime on the dollar, you know, why not? But this is an old school Simplicity magazine, $20, $7.70 shipping. This little Polaroid camera piece is funny. My wife, for once, I got her, she was going to throw this in the trash, and I was like, it's Polaroid, and it came with some other cameras that I just purchased. The other camera, actually, the first one I showed you, she was going to throw this away, and I was like, why don't we look this up, try to figure out what it is first. And we looked it up, and boom, got a $35 sale out of it. And it was just a random piece in a box, because what happens is you buy box lots, but you don't think, you buy it for one reason, because you saw something, but you don't really think about everything else in it, and the other stuff may have value, so it's always important you look up things. All right, what's the next thing here? Oh, there's the book again. All right, this I got like 3 weeks ago. Some of you guys may remember this one. I got two I purchased two. They're both Zeldas, so this is one of them. I don't know where the other one is. But I bought a box lot for like $3, and it had two Zelda action figures in it. And I also believe a barn that's listed. So, but one of the Zelda action figures, it goes back to Nintendo, by the way, for you gamers out there. It sold for $54.77 shipping. And I believe I had the other Zelda. That I believe they both sold like immediately after listing them. I might have to look for that. Here's an example. I always tell you that the skeleton keys sell. There's some keys that sold for $31.50. I could actually break them out individually and list eat them individually for like $5 to $10 a piece, but it's just a lot of work and effort. So we just usually, if we can get them for a good price, with a thumb on there is a lot. Thought I could get a little bit more for these, but I guess not on this one. But these may have been rusted or more beat up than others, or etc. Random brass chair I brought. It's like a little doll chair, little toy, like doll brass chair. So for $10, I could buy two energy drinks with that at least. Little action figure. What is he from? Oh, A-Team, old school. What was his name? Yeah, Mr. T was on the A-Team. Little action figure I brought, paid $15. I brought two of these at the same time, so this was profitable. Zero available, so they've both sold. So, you know, old school toys, they always sell. Remember that. Trans Am, remote toy car. Okay, this is a random toy car, didn't even have the remote. But what I've noticed is that people collect the old Trans Ams and Camaros. You know, just another awesome sale. Just a random toy that was in a box full of toys that I paid next to nothing for. This has been sitting around for a while. I thought it was neat, but people obviously didn't think it was that neat. But it did sell eventually. It was made out of teak wood. I think teak wood was real popular in the 70s and the 60s. I know that furniture made out of teak wood really sells for serious money. Learned that watching like American Pickers or something like that on TV. But here's a, but here it is. It sold eventually for $18. I did sit on this for a while. I think I paid like a dollar for it though. But it did take a lot longer to sell than I thought. Sometimes it's better just to get rid of stuff because it's just taking up space. This is from Hanover, Pennsylvania. Just random newspaper clippings that somebody has saved. It's from the Bicentennial edition of Hanover, Pennsylvania. I may have paid $2 for this. I paid nothing for this. So for $25. Here's some jewelry. Like, I never show you the jewelry that sold, but these sold on Etsy. And by the way, there's probably equal amount of things that sell on Etsy, but I hate listing the things that sell on Etsy because it's the way they come up, it doesn't come with the price and the shipping, it takes forever. But I wanted to show some things to you guys. Now here are some random clip-on earrings that I paid for. You guys have seen the huge box lots in previous videos that I purchased, but just to give you an idea, this collection of clip-on earrings here, I sold it for $40. For $10.95 shipping. And if you guys remember, like 2 months ago, I did a video and I purchased two huge shoe boxes, like packed, for $7 a piece. And this is just a portion of what was in there. They sell. It's a little annoying to sort through it all, but it's money in the bank. And what you gotta think is, all right, say you're working overtime at work. Okay, well, how much do you make an hour at work? Okay, now you're at work and you're miserable. Or you could be at home digging through a shoebox, make the same, or if not more, than if you were on overtime. So, that works for me. Alright, what's next here? Alright, this is I bought this early last spring. It may not even been this year. It may have been the spring before this year. Because I don't remember wearing a mask. So I don't even think it was this spring. This year was a weird year for all of us. But this is a Whiting milk can. Somebody had painted it blue. And they had it sitting out in their yard, in their garden. And of course it got a little rusty in the bottom and all. But it still sold for $50 for $16 shipping. And that's with And that's with the damage that it had the bottom, which, oh, great. Oh, there we go. With the damage. You see those, these are little holes that were in it. But it doesn't stop it from being an antique, you know. Let's see, what do we have next here? Alright, this is one of the items I purchased at that big toy auction. I did awesome there. I wanted so much of that stuff sold for that toy auction, but I've been trying to go start at the beginning and work my way up instead of just every week. Just whatever sold that week. It makes it real fast and simple. Even I might even do it every couple days. The videos will just flow then. But this is a Tonka bulldozer. Or I guess it's a dozer. Well, what is it? It's a loader, sorry. I don't want to pay, I think I paid $10, maybe $12 for this. Sold it for $60, and the customer paid $42.80 in shipping. And I think that's about all of it. But yeah, so that's the end of this compilation video. Remember, I have another auction video coming later this week. And remember to subscribe to my channel and to like my videos. They both help me tremendously with YouTube, so they move me up in their algorithm for their search engine, so I get more traffic from them and more people see or expose my videos. But that's about it. If there's anything that you guys would like to see more of or suggestions, please feel free to send a message. Any questions, feel free to shoot me a message. But I guess that's about it for this video. All right, until next time, guys.